We often take many of our body's everyday functions for granted. This past year is testament to that. By restricting our access to all the foreign experiences that set our soul on fire, we truly realised how good we had it. Not just at the sight of a beautiful sunset on holiday, but the sight of your favourite live band playing, or the sight of your niece laughing. We were forced to settle for the beauty that our own back door had to offer. Despite being given a whole year to actually acknowledge its brilliance, we still managed to complain. Our lack of practice appreciating the finer things in life that money can't buy has made us become complacent. So my intention with this video is to sow a seed of practice in your mind. You are watching this with your eyes. You have the gift of sight. Some people spent lockdown in literal darkness. I had the honour of speaking to someone who narrowly escaped this. Hey Siri, call my nephew.
Story of my life is every fucking picture that's taken of me, everyone's like, are you high? No, I'm just in severe fucking visual pain.
Aww, I'm sorry.
The age you start to hit puberty, your eyes accept vitamins that cause your corneas to solidify. When I hit that age, was my body rejecting that vitamin. Went to New Cross and, you know, got seen to, and the guy explained, this is your condition. And at the time, it didn't mean anything to me. I remember him saying, like, you know, it will progressively get worse. There's nothing we can do to stop it in its tracks at this point. We can give you hard contact lenses to replicate how your cornea should be, and it should help slow the process down. The two outcomes, which are two surgeries, the one being cross-collagen linking, which is where they put collagen in your eyes to help solidify, that was private. And I think that was meant to be like $4,000 per eye. That would have stopped the deterioration of the cornea, not necessarily improved the sight. Oh, I was like 11. I mean, they said at the point, like, the worst outcome is you're going to go blind from it. You know, they said, well, it's going to be, you know, years to decades before it reaches its final station, so I'm just like, I've got plenty of time. To put things into a better perspective, at its worst, I couldn't see my hand at a half outstretched arm. Couldn't see a car 6 feet away from me, and everything looked like a frosted glass window that you would see in a bathroom. The first things he said to me when he met me were like, I can tell that this has defeated you. He's like, I can see by your mannerisms that it's thrown you through a loop. That week before, I think I was just scatterbrained more than anything, because with so much that had gone on before then of like, stuff not happening the way you want it to, or like the way you think it's going to happen. So I really tried not to think too much about it. Like, it took me a while to hit me, because, you know, waiting almost 10 years for those words, it never really hit me. It was just like, fuck, it's happening soon. I think one of the biggest parts that, again, affected my confidence was the ability to talk to people purely on the basis of you don't realize how much you read facial expressions. I never even realized it until after surgery of how much I paid attention to the way people move, you know, just their overall body language as a way of recognizing people. Like, I remember points where, like, I could call someone out the other side of the street just by the way they moved, even though I couldn't see them well. And they'd be like, how the fuck do you see me? You can't see. And I'm just like, it's the way you move. What do you mean the way I move? Just the way you carry yourself. The way your legs are distanced apart when you walk. Are your arms by your sides or outwards? You know, do you walk with your arms in front or they stick by your side? Do you walk with the head bob or is your head perfectly, like, you know, level with the floor? Right? There's things you pick up on you don't even realise until when you don't need to rely on it. I never really realised how much I how much I paid attention to tone of voice as the way to understand how someone's feeling. And I find it's helped a lot in terms of communicating with people, that even though I may not look them directly in the eyes, I find that tone of voice really sells a lot. The amount of times friends have said they're okay, and I'm like, you're not, don't bullshit. Like, constantly wanted to drink, constantly wanted to smoke, and music did sound different. Like, I found that, like, songs that are, for the most part, like, a lot of the songs I listened to when I was struggling and when I was listening to now, they sound completely different. Like, they hit you on completely different levels. It helped a hell of a lot, and it did create more of a sense of comfort. I guess emotional release would be the best way to go about that.
Happy birthday.
Thank you.
Like, right now in lockdown, what would be, like, sick for you? You just got your sight back. You're like, right, this is what I want to do.
See, it's funny you mentioned that, because you were like, well, one thing would be sick that I'm sort of currently, like, just putting little bits towards.
Yeah.
So my music software is what I've been using since college. Purely because I'm using, no, that's the latest one, Reason 11. The one I'm using is Reason 5, which I think was released in probably 2003, 2004, and it's the only free edition I can get. Yeah, like, that's pretty much anything I'm good at, so.
You're good at loads of things.
Yeah, but music is like that. Music to me was always an escape, whether making it or listening. It was always something you can connect to without the need to see. Once you can hear and feel it. So for me, it was something that when everything hits the fan all at once, it's sort of lose your mind a bit to it. It was like that when making it. You sort of forget about everything else and just get lost in it.
So do you see where I'm going with this? For your birthday, I'll buy you the Reason Studio 11.
Bullshit.
That would be my absolute pleasure, that come payday next week, I will buy your Reason Studio 11 so you can make the best music. You're such a talent, Tobias.
I might just speak. For the longest time, I've been like, I need to get it, but other things have come up.
I'll get that for you. Happy birthday, and thank you for all your help.